Here we are, Field and Rural Life magazine with Annette Exeter. Great honour to be here with David. David, how has the show been going? And I take you've got rather a lot of interest here. Now, what do we have here?
Well, we have a coffin made purely from Dorset wool.
Absolutely wonderful, isn't it?
Isn't it? Yeah, it's green to the tea.
Green to the tea, that's wonderful.
Sir. And we've had no complaints at all from it. You know, people generally say with wool that it itches on their body, but nobody's complained at the moment.
Nobody's complained at the moment. Well, come on then, explain. How did all this come about?
Well, it goes back to June last year. And I was asked one night before the funeral exhibition at Stoneleigh, could I take two Dorset sheep the next day to the show?
Oh, right.
There's a picture of me there's a picture of the two sheep over there.
Yes, here we are.
There they are at the National Funeral Show. Now, at that point, I mean, I didn't know what to say, and I said, right, okay, I didn't know what show I was going to do for a start. And I said, well, it's a funeral show. Okay, so we went along. We went round for 2 hours around that show, and they thanked me very much and said they'd square up with me. And that was the beginning of it.
Yeah.
By 4 o'clock that night, Rachel Hainsworth, which is the lady on the end there.
Oh, right, yes.
She said to me, David, any chance you could come back? And I said, what, tomorrow? She said, yes, you've stolen the show. Everybody is remarking about it and it's there. And our sales pitch is going very, very well. So I went back. So then that started it because I said, look, you know, okay, do you want me to come along in onto this? And we formed the coffin committee, which is that lot there. And there's one from the wool board, myself.
Yes.
And this is the bloke who invented it.
Right.
And Rachel. And this chap sells more coffins in the country than anybody. 60% of all coffins, wood or whatever, are made by this bloke.
Oh, really?
Yep, he sells them all over the place.
Yes.
And that chap is the head wool buyer. He's Roger Hainsworth. So it's... Hainsworths have been going since 1783, so it's a long established company.
Yes.
And it's only since May, June this year that they've gone into this, and this has started to take off.
Really?
We've had inquiries for over a million.
A million, really?
In the States.
Have you?
Yeah. And so, you know, look, royalty is involved.
Yeah, I see the royalty's involved there.
And that's Adam again with the casket.
Yeah.
We ought to have had the Dorset sheep there.
So where are these made then?
They're made at Pudsey, Stanningley Pudsey,
right,
in Yorkshire.
Yeah.
In here, there's a story of where, they weave it from the wool. Well, it goes back from a scouring thing through to weaving, then the ladies there are checking it for quality, and there they are. They're making it into the welting in the manufactured. And that's the. You see, there's the MD, very young MD for the firm. It, as I say, it is. This is wool coming in, and the story is here. You see, and that's us. That's our farm with the wool sheep.
Yes.
And that's Roger coming out to have a look at them. And that's how it's gone. And
it
has taken off. And this year they decided this is an ashes box.
Oh, right.
So therefore, when you have the cremation, then you put the ashes in there, and you can either bury that or there. Also, since I've been going around the shows, a lot of people with horses, we do a bigger one.
Oh, really?
Because people love to keep their pet or the horse, you see, and so they have a box there. And that's how it's been going.
Well, absolute pleasure. Thank you
very
much indeed for your time. What a very, very, very interesting product. And we'll speak to you soon. Thank you very much.
Thank you.